is fall like pumpkins, and I feel like we've been talking about them a lot lately. Good reason, good reason. Today, we're whipping up a delicious pumpkin soup with Chef Marcel Cocit. Welcome, Chef.
Thank you. Thanks for having me.
You're
back
in the kitchen with me.
What's up, my brother?
I'm excited because this looks and smells amazing, and our counter, Debbie, Maria, and Kim can
tell us. So far, so good.
How
good
life
is.
Did he pass the test?
Because
I made this recipe super, super simple because of Ken.
Wait a minute. Everything just kind of took a little turn there. We were just going like, great, I'm in the kitchen with the chef.
I love you, I know.
But this is simple for guys like me.
Yes.
And it's true, but it has not simple on flavors, man. It is packed with flavors.
And I created this many years ago. I used to teach private cooking classes, and my client wanted pumpkin soup. So here we are. It's my go-to recipe for years.
Fantastic.
Again, simple to make. So let's get
right into it. So we got some onions, some garlic in there, a little bit of butter.
And some butter. You got to have butter. Everything's better with butter.
Can you say it one more time before I like the way you say it?
Butter. Everything's better with butter.
Thank you very much. How long do we let that...
We're going to cook this down probably like 3-4 minutes.
Okay.
Blend all the beautiful flavors together.
Okay,
right?
Very good. And then we start adding some more good stuff.
We are going to add some apples.
Okay.
All right.
Now, does it matter what kind of apples? Those look like Granny Smith.
I like the Granny Smith apples. Okay. They're just nicer. They're not too sweet because we're going to add some other stuff in there.
Okay.
I really like, and you know, apples, pumpkin, it's the fall, so everybody, you know, it's a match made in heaven, right?
Beautiful. Do we go pumpkins next? No,
let's
we go
with the spices. We have some cinnamon.
Oh, gosh, you can taste it.
Yummy.
We need the cinnamon. We have some nutmeg.
Okay, these are fall flavors like we talked about.
Let's
go ahead.
Some ginger.
I'll put this down here for you. I'll take
that. There you go. Some fresh thyme. I love the thyme. You can use some sage too, but I love the thyme in there.
Okay.
If you use sage, be careful because it could be very overpowering.
Now, I came in a little bit earlier and I, you know, roasted some pumpkin and pureed it, you know, because I had some extra time on my hands. But you don't need to.
I think it was like 2 weeks ago he started this, right?
The pumpkins? That's right. No, but you said we don't need to do that.
No, you don't. You can use canned pumpkin. I'm a big fan. I want to make it simple for everyone.
Right.
But if you want to use fresh pumpkins, by all means, use the sugar pumpkins. They're much sweeter. Mm. You just roast them. It's going to give a nice, bold, rustic flavor. Mm. But it's going to be just as good. Because let me tell you something. Who has time to roast pumpkins other than Cameron?
Yeah, I get up early and make sure I make it.
He gets up early. He goes to the gym. We know your routine. I get it.
Now, you're going with a little veggie broth in there, too.
We are going with some veggie broth.
Okay.
Okay.
Versus anything else, like chicken broth or anything like
that?
You
could do chicken broth as well. I like the veggie broth. If you're trying to keep it vegetarian, go with the veggie broth.
And I like that you're not using heavy cream.
I know.
Oh, that's going to come up. That's coming up. Way ahead, baby.
But we have some swap outs.
We have swap outs. Okay.
We're going to have some heavy cream.
We'll have some swap out, and we're putting water.
Okay.
Now, the reason for water is if you use too much of any kind of broth, it's going to overpower the soup. You want it to taste like pumpkin, not broth, right? So that'll balance it out.
Okay, very good. And how long do we let that sort of simmer there on the...
We will cook this down for about 15 to 20 minutes until the apples are nice and tender.
Is that how you know it's ready? You check those apples
the apples. And then, fast forward right here. I'm going to have you do the honors.
Oh,
we have a hand.
Wait a minute.
Handheld blender, which is great. Oh, my God. Oh, my God.
It's okay. Everybody's going to be all right.
It's okay. It's okay.
When there's a tool in the kitchen. Oh, my God.
Look at him.
Seriously.
Listen, it's not like bench pressing here, okay? Be careful now. Come on.
This is what I'm made for.
This is great.
I was made to use kitchen tools.
Were you?
So the handheld blender's great.
Not even
Were you, Cameron?
You can use a food processor or a blender. Just do it in batches, of course.
Okay. Yeah, and after we blend them, add.
Then, Deb, we have the heavy cream. You got to have some heavy cream.
That's not much, Marcel.
No, half a cup. That's it. Half a cup of that. And then another secret. Look at this.
Maple syrup.
Beautiful. No, but you can use maple syrup. This is honey.
That's a little
sweet. You need that honey.
That was a surprise.
Hey, honey, we need some honey.
Do you taste the little honey, little sweetness in there?
I thought it was the apples.
I did, too.
Then you just blend this together.
Okay, very good.
Very simple.
Now, I want to talk about the fact that some people, you know, watch their dairy intake.
Yeah.
You've got some great swap outs.
Yeah, so swap outs. My wife does not eat dairy.
Okay.
So what I do at the house is basically I'll use olive oil, coconut oil, avocado oil. We use a lot of avocado oil.
Oh, to saute instead of the butter. Oh, okay. Yeah.
And then you can use coconut milk or almond milk, which is great.
For sure.
Or soy if you want the soy instead of the cream. And it's vegan.
How about this? You ready for this? I'm going to impress everybody. This is going to be fantastic. Or you could use raw cashews. You put them in there before you blend them up, and it creates a creamy essence.
You are a vegan. I love you.
This is something he learned on the show just 2 days ago.
Okay. Well, you know what, Deb? You didn't tell me that.
You know what? Listen, you're always learning, and that's what the show's about.
I pay attention. That's the truth. Now, I see some salt and pepper over there. I feel like I'm too astray there.
Well, yeah, obviously, you got to add the salt and pepper in there, you know. And that's to taste, to see how much you want, you know. Everybody's different.
So while you guys ladle some soup into your bowls, you're going to love this, Cam Cam. I would just like to congratulate you, Marcel, on your 10 years of your catering
business. Thank you. It's been a long time. I've been cooking for over 25 years, and it's been a long time. We started this catering business 10 years ago with my wife, married to food catering, and it's been incredible. Aww. She does the bar aspect of the business. She's a mixologist, so she does that, and I do the food, of course. We are a full-service catering company. We have servers, chefs, bartenders. We do rentals. We do it all.
You do it all.
Yeah, this Saturday we're doing an event. She's doing one event. I'm doing another event. Oh, wow, I'm actually doing an event for somebody that comes to the show.
Oh.
You know Dylan Neal.
Oh, Dylan!
I'm doing his 50th birthday party.
Whoa.
And she's doing a 40th birthday party.
Do we get invited?
He looks amazing.
Dylan?
50? He doesn't look a day over 49.
Invites must have been lost in the mail.
I guess it's probably coming. The invitation.
Yeah.
Sure.
The invitation's coming. 7 o'clock call time on Saturday.
Okay, quick garnishes. Here we go.
Yes, pumpkin seeds.
Okay.
Which
are super healthy, everybody. So fantastic.
Right.
They're actually very good for a lot of different reasons. I don't want to bore you with all the details.
Don't bore, but they're really good. Yeah. And then you got a little fresh thyme.
Yeah.
You can get creative. You could do some chopped apples for garnish, you know.
Get in there. Give it a
little
taste.
Little cream in there.
I'm going to have a taste even before the cream.
While you guys are having that, I'm going to let everyone at home know that you can find this recipe on HallmarkChannel.com.
Wow.